I'm Dana Tran from thinktuitive.com, and in this last lesson, we'll walk through how to build a simple messenger bot with the help of Chatfuel. Before you start and test out Chatfuel, I do recommend creating a new Facebook page to build your messenger bot. Think of it like your secret lab to run experiments and tests. To do this, go to Facebook, click on the settings drop-down menu in the top right-hand corner, and click on Create a New Facebook Page, then follow the on-screen instructions. Now, before we dive into the tutorial, I did want to mention that I have a free Chatfuel 10-step checklist to help you build a Facebook Messenger bot. It basically lists the 10 things you might want to review or set up before you launch your bot. Just go to bit.ly/chatfuel-checklist and get DanaBot, that's my messenger bot, to send this PDF to your messenger inbox. Next, you'll need to create a Chatfuel account. On your laptop or desktop, go to chatfuel.com. Click on the Get Started button in the upper right-hand corner. You'll be asked to log into Facebook and give Chatfuel access to your profile and Facebook page. Once you have an account created, you'll be redirected to Chatfuel and see the dashboard. Chatfuel has several templates you can go through, but let's just create a new bot. To connect this bot to your test Facebook page, just click on Connect to Facebook up in the top right corner, find the right page, and click on the Connect to Page button. Now that you created an account and linked it to a Facebook page, let's take a quick tour in Chatfuel. First, you have the Chatfuel dashboard. This is where you can see a list of all your bots. If you click on the three dots, this is also where you can rename the bot that you just created. If you open a specific bot, you should see a total of 7 options on your left-hand side. Let's first talk about the Automate tab, which is where you'll be spending the majority of your time and where you can build and add content to your messenger bot. Up at the top, you should see 2 blocks. The welcome message block stores the first message the user receives from your messenger bot, and default answer, which is a message that gets sent automatically when your messenger bot does not know how to respond to a user. Since this is an introduction, we'll just work on setting up a main gallery and a welcome message. We'll get rid of all these placeholder cards by clicking on the garbage icon. Then we'll add a text card and enter in some text. Let's say hello. If you type in 2 curly brackets, a menu will pop up which allows you to pull in the user's first name to make the message a little more personalized. When a user interacts with your messenger bot, you'll automatically have access to their basic Facebook information, like their first name. Chatfuel does not have a built-in emoji feature, but you can easily add emojis by pressing Control Command Spacebar on a Mac. And if you're on a PC, you can easily copy and paste from online emoji sites. Let's also add an image card and upload an animated GIF. Let's click and drag this image card to the top. To make it easier for users to read your message, we'll add in a 2-second typing delay. Then we'll click and drag to position this delay in between the image and the text card. There's also no need to save your changes. They are saved automatically. You can tell by the green status icon located under the name of your bot. To preview what you just built, just click this test button in the upper right-hand corner. Then grab your phone. You should see something like this. To allow users to interact with your bot, you can add buttons or quick replies. When users tap on a button, you can send users a new message. In this case, let's create a new button called Main that redirects users to a new block, also called main. On the left-hand side, let's click to open our new main block and click to add a gallery. Let's upload an image. And I usually prefer the horizontal image, so let's click on Next. Make a few adjustments. Then click Done. Then we'll add a heading and a description. I want a total of 3 cards in this gallery, so I'll just click on the plus sign to add more cards. If you repeat the same steps for the remaining 2 cards in this gallery, you should end up with something like this. Before I show you a preview of this gallery on the phone, I just wanted to quickly mention that you can create groups to store various blocks. It really helps to keep things a little more organized. For example, you can rename this group to Main Blocks, then simply click and drag this main block into the new group. We can also click and drag this group up to the top. Now, let's preview this gallery on a mobile phone. This is what I basically did to build Thinktuitive's main bot gallery. It's simply a gallery card with buttons that take users to other blocks. Other than directing users to another block, a button can also open a website, call a phone number, provide users with a quick and easy way to share your bot, or make a purchase directly inside your Messenger bot. To enable payments, you'll need to complete the payment setup wizard. Chatfuel also has other cards that you can use to build your bot. One of the cards that I use quite often is the go-to block, which redirects users to a different block depending on who they are or their interests. If you click on the plus icon, you'll also see all the other additional Chatfuel plugins. I won't go through how to use them in detail, but the popular ones I would say are the JSON API, where you can send and get data from a third-party application, user input, where you can collect information from users to segment your audience, send an email notification to yourself, set up a live chat so that the bot does not interrupt your conversation with a user, save information by updating a user attribute, and a messenger bot can also send audio and video files. A question I often get is writing tips when it comes to bot messages. I won't be able to cover copywriting tips in full detail in this tutorial, but here's 2 of my favorite message templates to help you get started. First, you could start with sending 3 short messages. To make it easier to read, you can also add in some delays in between each message. Then follow up with a call to action. You can use quick replies or buttons. Just keep in mind, you're sending a message, so write using short sentences. You can also add emojis to make your message more fun and engaging. My second recommended template starts with an image, followed by some text, then a call to action. If you're wondering why I start with an image, it's because images tend to be more captivating. If you start with a text, it might not even get seen. Before we move on to the next section, I'd like to point out that you can also create sequences in Chatfuel. Just in case you don't know what a sequence is, it's basically a series of messages that gets sent based on a preset time interval. You can use this feature to create onboarding sequences, a mini course, or send a reminder for an upcoming event or challenge. Like a group, you can rename the sequence. Let's call this one mini course. And by default, when you create a new sequence, you'll see 3 message blocks with a schedule in the first column. In this example, this first message gets sent immediately, the second message gets sent after 1 day, and for the third message, we can change it to send after 5, hours. You can also view more stats for each message in the sequence by hovering over each one. So that's it for the Automate tab. Next, we have Setup AI. This is where you can teach your bot to understand basic words. For example, you can add an AI rule that tells the bot if the user says something similar to "hi," then the bot replies with "hello." You can also create multiple random answers to make your bot sound a little less robotic. For example, we can add a second answer to say, "hey there." Instead of sending text, you can also send an existing block. Suppose a user types in "main," then send the existing block, "main." Here's what that'll look like on a mobile phone. If you type in "hi," you should get a reply that says, "hello there." If you type in "main," the bot will redirect you to the main gallery. Next, we have the People tab, where the majority of the feature is only available to those on the Pro Chatfuel plan. But I still want to give you a quick overview. The People tab is where you can see who has interacted with your Messenger bot. You can search for a user, filter the list, subscribe users into a sequence, export user information into a spreadsheet, and even update user information by clicking on the user's name. For example, I can manually change my subscriber user attribute from monthly to weekly. You'll notice that Chatfuel does not have a built-in live chat feature. So to reply to live messages from your users, just click on the inbox from your Facebook page, or you can download the Page Manager app. Once you have a list of subscribers, you should also try to engage with them and send out useful new content. You can do this by sending out a broadcast. If you're currently using email marketing, then you're probably familiar with this feature. In Chatfuel, you have the option of delivering the message right away, create a trigger-based message, or schedule a message to be sent at a later date and time. Let's start by choosing the message type. In this case, let's suppose we're sending out a subscription message and creating a broadcast message is no different than creating any other content in Chatfuel. Just select the card you want to add and add the content. Let's say, "Hi, did you see my new article about bots and lead scoring?" And we'll add a button to take users to read the article. You can also create a filter to only send this message to a specific target audience. With Chatfuel, you also have the ability to send a message according to the user's time zone, which is quite handy since you don't want the user's phone to beep at 3 a.m. in the morning. And since there's only one person subscribed to this test bot, you can toggle the schedule on to send this broadcast. You should be the only one to receive a message. Up next is the Configure tab. There's many options here, but I just wanted to point out that this is where you can create a persistent menu, which appears at the bottom of the Messenger screen. Here's what it'll look like on your phone. To get rid of the branding in the persistent menu, you'll need to upgrade to Chatfuel's Pro plan. Moving on, we have the Grow tab, which is where you can access all the different widgets and tools to help you promote your Messenger bot. You can set up a customer chat plugin, which allows users to interact with your Messenger bot directly on your site. There's a live example of the chat customer plugin located on Chatfuel's main site if you want to test it out. This is also where you can create a landing page for your Messenger bot. The other popular growth tool is the Acquire Users from Comments tool, where you can get your bot to automatically message any users who who comment on your Facebook posts. It's a really effective way to drive more traffic to your bot and to get more bot subscribers. If you scroll down, you'll also see the option to create a Send to Messenger widget to embed on your site. Last but not least, we have the Analyze tab. As a new bot, you probably won't see any stats right now. But once your bot is launched, you'll start to see graphs and charts so that you can monitor the performance of your Messenger bot. Now that you know how a Messenger bot works, I wanted to mention a few additional bot resources. First, if you're looking for a more in-depth course with best practices, writing tips, and step-by-step instructions on how to build an interactive Messenger bot, you can check out my Bot Essentials Premium course. If you're looking for other additional free resources, I recommend checking out my site, thinktuitive.com, join the Chatfuel community on Facebook, or refer to the Chatfuel documentation. You can find the links to all of this, including my Bot Essentials Premium course, in the description below. And also don't forget to download your free 10-step checklist to help you build your Facebook Messenger bot. So thanks so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this Chatfuel tutorial. If you found it useful, please share it and be sure to click on the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on other free video tutorials on Messenger bots. So have fun building your Chatfuel Messenger bot. I'm Dina Tran, and bye for now.